Hi, I'm James McGuire, and on today's video, we're talking about the mobile device management market. We'll look at some of the challenges the companies face with MDM and also some of the possible solutions for those challenges. To discuss that, I'm joined by a major industry expert. With me is Jason Meller, Chief Executive Officer of Collide. Jason, very good to have you with us today.
Thank you for having me.
So the MDM market is a pretty hot market. It saw about $5 billion worth of revenue last year. It's growing about 20 to 25% a year. One pundit predicted that it would hit $21 billion by the end of this decade. So there's a lot of growth, but not everything is perfect for those companies using MDM. What are some of the challenges involved with this fast-growing market?
Well, you mentioned the massive amount of growth, and that's primarily being driven by the new compliance standards that are really coming to bear. A lot of companies that are selling business to business, particularly SaaS companies, they have to pass new style audits like SOC 2, which really require the devices are under some kind of management. And that's where MDM really comes into play. And fundamentally, organizations for the first time, before they're really needing to from a IT perspective, they need to pass these audits. So they're finding these devices and they're putting them under management and they're buying MDM style solutions for them. Now, the thing is, when they go to look for those solutions, fundamentally, they're looking to solve every single IT management and security challenge with this one thing. But MDM isn't really good at solving everything. It's particularly good at getting the device initially in the state that you want it in from a security perspective, making sure that right out of the cellophane, out of the box, it has disk encryption, you know, the firewall is on, so on and so forth. But once the end user really gets to use it on a daily basis, that's where the story starts to fall apart and relatively rapidly. For instance, one of the most important things that you have to reason about in the security space is making sure that the computer has its latest patches, and not just the computer, but like the web browser and other critical software. Well, MDM doesn't have a great answer to that. And in fact, most of the companies that we talk to, they, despite rolling out MDM, they still have significant lag time between when the device is fully patched from when the device is offered the patch. That lag time can often be in the order of weeks. Sometimes it's even longer than that. And these patches, they contain critical things that you need to install. Otherwise, you could be the victim of a drive-by malware attack or things of that nature. So reducing that lag time isn't something that MDMs have been particularly good at. And so far, IT admins have now been faced with building their own solutions that rely on forcing reboots and things like that to make sure that those things are happening. But that's just one of many things. Anything that requires nuanced end user consideration, where the end user really needs to think about, when do I want to do this? Is this sensitive data that's on my device? MDM just doesn't have an answer for it. And those are things that are really important, just as important if the device itself is encrypted.
All right, so those are some of the challenges in the market, but why is now such an important time for MDM, and what issues are most urgent for companies to address?
So I think there's a number of things that are driving the adoption of increasing the security and compliance of devices. I already mentioned these compliance audits like SOC 2, GDPR. Those are things that are driving it, but there's also just this recent wake-up call that IT and security administrators have realized, like, hey, there are a number of companies right now that are getting hacked. And the way that they are getting hacked is that these devices are being compromised because they're not being up to date in a timely manner. But more importantly, the way that our users are authenticating, usually via some sort of SSO provider, they're signing in with their username and password, and then they have that two-factor authentication. Well, turns out that two-factor authentication isn't good enough to resist, I think, the more recent attempts at phishing. We saw recently with one of the major hacks, like Uber is a good example of this, where the attacker, despite the fact that they had two-factor auth, they were able to convince, trick that user into either sharing the passcode, or in Uber's case specifically, they got the user they social engineered them to actually click a button or tap a button on their phone to confirm the two-factor access. If you had asked IT administrators just a year ago, is two-factor auth sufficient? They would have all said, yes, that's an industry standard. But since these hacks, especially the ones that ended in 2022, suddenly people are thinking, well, two-factor isn't enough anymore. We really need to ensure that devices are the things that are used to tie in with the authentication. And that's what's driving this idea of zero trust methodology, or you may have heard of it as referred to as Beyond Corp. These are major initiatives that many companies are taking on. And part of device trust and zero trust is making sure that the device is known to the company, is trusted, and is in the right posture. And that's what's really driving, I think, the focus on this area right now.
Interesting. So, all right. So let's take a minute to drill down into the Collide offerings. I mean, how is Collide addressing the MDM needs of its clients? I mean, what's the Collide advantage in terms of the overall market?
Yeah. So Collide, our company, was founded on the premise of really not trying to extract the end users out of the problem, but let's see if the end users who have the most context in what they're doing, they kind of understand what's going on. How do we actually leverage their time and attention to get the device in its most secure state possible? Now, this would have been a fool's errand if you asked IT and security administrators at any point in history. End users are typically perceived as the enemy, or the at least the source of many of these compromises. We read about it all the time. But we see so much potential in end users actually being able to assist IT and security teams. Now, fundamentally, MDM type of software is constrained by one reality. And that reality is, in order for you to be able to fix the problem, it must be something that can be automated. It must be something where the end user isn't involved at all, and you have to force it on, or a script needs to run to set up the setting in the right way. And that requires really careful coordination with the OS vendors. And fundamentally, it's a limited way to ensure security and compliance on a device. There are much more nuanced instances. We mentioned updates as one of them earlier, but let's think about another one, like sensitive data on the device. I can't tell you the amount of engineers or customer service reps that have this treasure trove of sensitive information that's just sitting in their downloads folder. And what's the MDM solution for that? There really isn't one. You can't go in there and just try to find it, you know, automatically and delete it. What if that was in the user was in the process of using it, or they really needed it? You really need the end user to collaborate with you to solve a lot of these challenges. So that's what we've set off to do inside of Collide. Is we wanted to endeavor to create a product that enables that type of conversation between the IT administrators and the end users. So what are the components that make that possible? Well, with Collide, what we've stumbled upon is that if you use the authentication flow, like when you're signing into stuff, as a place to say, wait a second, you're trying to sign into this app, but your device is really not in the state that we would like it in before we let you into this app that has all of this sensitive data. So we would like you to do X, Y, and Z. And if you do those things, you can sign in. That's never been tried before, and I think a meaningful way in our industry. And that's exactly what Collide does. We present you that message. We give you the end user step-by-step instructions on how to fix it. And then they do fix it. And that's the key, because if they don't fix it, they can't sign in and do the things that they need to do their job. And what we found is that end users understand that. That's a very transactional cause and effect type of thing. They understand if I don't have the ability, if my device isn't in a good state, then I shouldn't have access to the most sensitive intellectual property or data that my company has. If I'm not doing my updates on time, yes, that makes sense that I shouldn't be able to get access to the keys to the kingdom. And that simple nuance in how that interaction works can drive so many more compliance initiatives inside of your organization. You can actually, if you can detect it and you can enumerate to an end user how to fix it, then Collide can be the thing to get you to that metric to 100%. That's never been possible before. And that's what's so fundamentally different about our offering compared to a traditional automated MDM provider. And you can keep your MDM provider. You don't have to, this isn't an either or. Use the MDM for what it's good for. Make sure that, you know, file vault encryption is on. But beyond that, get the end users to solve a lot of these issues. You'll find that to be a much better long-term solution. And Collide's created a product to allow you to do that at scale. And that's really what we're offering.
So really, Collide is requiring the users to be more involved, more invested in their own security process. It seems like they're going to learn more about it, be more involved with it.
Yeah, that's totally true. In order for you to be able to communicate to an end user, you have to explain not just the what, but the why. Why is this important? Why does it matter that I don't have my two-factor backup codes sitting on my desktop? Well, the end user may not know why. And by getting them to fix it and then teaching them the why, the recidivism rate that they're likely to do it again is going to be extremely low. We've also seen that on the update side as well for now the customers that have deployed this. At first, a user does get blocked, but they learn very quickly what the system is really looking for intuitively. Then the next time they're in their web browser, they're on Google Chrome or Firefox or whatever it is, and they see that little badge like, oh, it's time to update. They don't wait for it to turn like a crimson red. They click it right away because they know if they don't, the company is going to eventually block their access to a number of different apps that they need to do their job. So then they start to learn to preemptively anticipate that and do that. And that's been the goal of IT security training since its invention. Mm-hmm. But now with the right type of system and process in place to encourage that behavior, we can actually achieve it. That is novel, as far as I know. I don't think that's ever been actually not just attempted, but actually achieved. And that's what we've done.
All right, let's look ahead to the future of MDM. I mean, what are a few key milestones we can expect? And maybe most important, how can companies get ready for them now?
So I think the future is going to be really interesting when it comes to mobile device management. We're already seeing a lot of these shifts. We're in the midst of many of them. I think the biggest shift that we're starting to see is that the diversity and types of devices that end users or employees are using to do their work is increasing. I can't tell you the amount of companies that have come to us because they have an increasing number of Linux devices that are coming in, and they don't have any answer for that. There is no MDM for Linux at all. So they're like, all right, well, how do we solve this issue? So I think the diversity of devices is going to continue to increase. The amount of folks that are working remotely, obviously, since the pandemic, that's toothpaste that's out of the tube. You're not putting that back in. And we need to be in a position as security and IT practitioners to enable these people to work securely from any location with any possible device. As that becomes the challenge, trying to centralize all the management under one OS vendor or one type of MDM product becomes really problematic. So what's the common thread that runs among them? It's the end user. The end users are the key, leveraging their ability to change the settings on their computer to actually get the computers in the right state. We think that's the future. So the thing that we really see as being a fundamental change in the future is the changes in how two-factor authentication is now being subverted by attackers, right? So I mentioned this earlier, we think that's going to increase over time. And what sort of comes into consideration with that is also how people are structuring their network security architecture and how they're really protecting these systems. So fundamentally, we think things like the VPN, which are the classic ways of like you create this really strong outer barrier, and then once you're into the private network, you're in. We think that that's going away. And we fundamentally think that zero trust, or beyond corp as Google has called it, will be the thing that actually drives, you know, more modern network style architectures for accessing apps. SaaS apps have taken over our world. We don't see that going away. We think more and more apps that you use on a regular basis for business are going to be SaaS based. They're going to be accessible potentially by any device. And so the future really relies on organizations understanding that they need to control which devices truly can access those apps. And Zero Trust, Beyond Corp are going to be the major initiatives that organizations endeavor to embark on to actually solve that problem.
Jason, that's a lot of great stuff. I think you really covered it. Thank you so much for sharing your expertise today. Please come back and talk with us again sometime.
Oh, well, thank you for having me. And for folks that are really interested in learning more about this, obviously we have a really exciting product launch that's like the basis of why we're talking about this. You can learn more about Collide at collide.com. That's K-O-L-I-D-E.com. And for more thoughts like this, if you want to follow me on Twitter, you can follow me at J Meller, J-M-E-L-L-E-R.